Kamali, taking you through some of the things people are talking about and some of the stuff they're sharing around the world on Newsfeed today. Trump says a thing about India and it's quickly denied by India. We have the latest from India. A tribe in the Amazon is contacted for the first time in a while, raising fears for their safety. A wholesome, empowering new internet challenge is going viral, and it was started with the help of Blue Ivy. And this guy, that one at the bottom, is welcoming a new boss into the house he lives in animals doing stuff. This one is staying put. And top of our news feed, Donald Trump said he was asked to mediate between India and Pakistan over Kashmir. India says no such conversation took place. Here's the moment, while sitting next to the Prime Minister of Pakistan, Imran Khan, that the President of the United States made that claim. Have a listen.
So I was with Prime Minister Modi 2 weeks ago, and we talked about this subject, and he actually said, would you like to be a mediator or arbitrator? I said, where? He said, Kashmir. Because this has been going on for many, many years. I was surprised at how long it's been going on. Long.
70 years.
I think they'd like to see it resolved, and I think you'd like to see it resolved. And if I can help, I would love to be a mediator. It shouldn't be.
And this is what the response has been over in India. Here's Nia.
U.S. President Donald Trump is not new to controversies, but this time, comments that he's made have kicked up a storm here on the Indian subcontinent. While hosting the Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan, Mr. Trump claimed that Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi had asked him to mediate between India and Pakistan on the issue of Kashmir, a state that both India and Pakistan stake claim to but only govern in parts. It's a conflict that's over seven decades old, but it's been renewed because of what Donald Trump said. Now, this is what India's response has been. They've said, we've seen his remarks to the press that he's ready to mediate. No such request has been made by Prime Minister Modi. It has been India's consistent position that all outstanding issues with Pakistan are discussed only bilaterally. And effectively, that's the Indian administration saying that Mr. Modi made no such comment. So many are asking why Trump claimed that Mr. Modi had. Shashi Tharoor, an Indian politician, had this to say, I honestly don't think Trump has the slightest idea what he's talking about. He has either not been briefed or not understood what Modi was saying on what India's position is on third-party mediation. You had a congressman from the US, Brad Sherman, say this. Everyone who knows anything about foreign policy in South Asia knows India consistently opposes third-party mediation on Kashmir. Everyone knows Modi would never suggest such a thing. Trump's statement is amateurish and delusional and embarrassing. He also goes on to say that he has personally apologized to India's ambassador to the United States on behalf of Trump's comments. You had Edward Luce say this, unlike many of Trump's lies, this one causes instant harm to Trump and America's interests. First, because it angers a natural ally that is the best bulwark against a rising China. And second, it pollutes whatever trust remains between him and Modi. Remember, Donald Trump has been personally attacking Prime Minister Modi over various issues on the trade front. And this is only going to make a bad situation worse. And you've got Nirupama Subramaniam saying the comment by the Indian Foreign Ministry was perhaps the most polite way of saying that Trump was lying. And finally, Dhruv Jaishankar putting out this GIF saying, to everybody who's upset about this, please calm down. This is not the first time that Trump has made a controversial comment. It won't be the last.
No, it will not be. Let's take a look at some of the other things that caught our eye on social media. A police officer in America wrote on Facebook that Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez should be shot. One of the cops, Charlie Rispoli, wrote, this vile idiot needs a round, and not the kind she used to serve. Now, AOC was once a bartender. Hilarious. It was liked by someone called Angelo Varisco. They have both been fired. And what makes this story even stranger is that the former cops were commenting on a fake story which was labeled as satire on Facebook. The man who wrote the comment about a round was a police officer for 14 years. A A student in Kenya who graduated with a top degree from the University of Nairobi was on a TV show there saying he was now homeless and had thought about killing himself. His appearance led to people posting their own experience of getting qualifications and being unable to get a job using the hashtag #FirstClassBetrayal. The unemployment rate in Kenya is more than 9%. Plates for sale at a store called Macy's in the US, which insensitively show portion size, have been banned from sale after a tweet. The tweet came from someone called Ali Ward, who asked how she could get them banned. She said they are body shaming. 39% of US adults are clinically obese, the highest rate of any developed nation. And video of NBA star Shaquille O'Neal at a music festival in Belgium is being shared. As you can see, he dominates the mosh during a set by Kill the Noise. This video of him mashing it up has been viewed 8 million times.
What the hell are you doing out here, Picard? Saving the galaxy?
And this is a teaser trailer for the Amazon Prime-based new foray into the Star Trek universe. It's called Picard, after Jean-Luc, and it looks like a redemption story-ish with a captain somehow saving the galaxy from someone who he had first felt the need to protect. It has some of our favorites from those 90s Star Trek TV series. Data is back from Next Generation, and Seven of Nine is back from Voyager. And Commander Riker, or rather the actor who plays him, tweeted yesterday that he will be part of the show too. Now to Brazil, and there has been some contact with one of the world's least contacted tribes. Take a look.
There are people who've not had contact with anyone from any society. There are people who've been persecuted for more than 519 years. They live on that land there, but we have never had any contact. We've always known that they are there, in the middle of that great forest. They've been threatened by many things, from loggers, hunters, fishermen, farmers.
Me the most in the life of the Awa, the isolated Indians in the Ti Arariboa, is that they teach children not to cry so that no one knows where they are. How sad to live a life in constant fear.
We have got together and organized a team to protect the territory. We were worried and are worried about future generations and about the isolated tribes that we have never seen, but which our grandparents told us of.
Some other stories you need to know this Tuesday. The Verge website have exposed Facebook Kids chat service that is not a kids-only space anymore. Messenger Kids was launched in 2017 and was sold as a place where children under the age of 13 could talk, but only to people their parents had approved of. Now it's been revealed that a design flaw allows kids to be in chat groups with people they don't know. Facebook have closed those groups and contacted the parents involved. They're being accused of violating children's online privacy and possibly other privacy laws in the US and elsewhere in the world. The Washington Post report that they have found at least 12 phony pages selling Facebook's new cryptocurrency Libra. And ironically, they're on Facebook. The pages were removed only after Facebook was told about them by the Washington Post, a damning development for a company who plans to sell a new currency to its millions of users. And this is a really well put together fake website for Libra. Now, the revelation comes as Facebook is desperately trying to get regulatory approval for their currency. But the fact there are fake pages on their own pages does not bode well for Facebook's ability to keep people safe. There are massive wildfires in the Arctic right now, and the burning released as much carbon last month as Sweden does in an entire year. The fact the fires are so big and in that geographical area is, scientists say, very unusual. They say it's yet another example of the way climate is changing rapidly this year.
Although wildfires are common in the Northern Hemisphere between May and October, the latitude, meaning you know the fact that they're so high up, and the intensity of these fires is particularly unusual. The ongoing fires have been most severe in Alaska and in Siberia. And again, according to the EU Copernicus, some have been large enough to cover almost 100,000 football pitches.
And next, we bring you news of the internet's latest viral challenge, and this one is neither gross nor dangerous, it is super positive. Just the sort of thing the internet should be doing more of. And Britain has a new prime minister. It's a man who once said that women in burqas look like postboxes and bank robbers, and who wrote an offensive poem about the president of Turkey. His name's Boris Johnson. So things are changing at number 10 at Downing Street, but one thing that will stay the same is this guy. It's Larry the Cat. It's Downing Street's official mouncer, meaning he catches mice. Now, he's been in his job since 2011, so he's seen off two other prime ministers, David Cameron and Theresa May. He's outlasted those two. Will he outlast Bojo? Many hope he will. And that will do you from the newsfeed team. Reach out to me with your questions, comments, complaints, and suggestions. You'll find me at Kamali Melbourne. You'll find us 24/7 on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and follow me on Twitter. Follow, subscribe, and add. See you again tomorrow.